There cannot possibly be more excitement about Bridgerton and the fact that that story is set to continue. I know you've just wrapped on season two. Can you talk about what the show has meant for you and what it's like to be a part of the phenomenon that it now is, undisputably?
Gosh, what has the show meant for me? Family, is a really good word to start off with. It's created a really beautiful family, not only in the cast, but the crew. And the producers, and obviously Shonda, and that whole machine, and Netflix. We really are supported on our little show. We had no idea that it was going to break as hugely as it did. So grateful to all the fans who were so loyal to the books, Julia Quinn's books, but yet really embraced what we did with it and how we have kind of extended that world for Julia Quinn and Bridgerton and the characters in it. Well, I think what we've got to understand is that we are talking and coming from Julia Quinn's books, and every single book has a different character, is talking about a different character. So for me, it's really exciting when you can... I don't know whether there's any kind of popular drama that does that. Yes, we have the banner, the umbrella of Bridgerton, but within that world, characters come in and out, and the storylines are dramatically changed because a new love interest, because a character is driving that season, as in the books. And yeah, as I say, I can't think of anywhere else where there is a drama that does that. So I know it's hard for some people who really invest in people, in the characters, in the show. I totally understand that, but I would urge them to be equally excited for new storyline and new characters that are coming in.
It's obviously always a pleasure to be a queen, but can you talk a little bit about this particular queen?
Yeah, gosh, she is probably the love of my life at the moment. I love the development that we're doing with her. She's in it a little bit more this season, which is great for me. So I can't wait for people to see how she's developed and what kind of quirk, creative mischief that we're going to get up to.
We were talking to Phoebe not that long ago at her premiere for her new film, the amazing The Colour Room, and she was joking that she never wants the show to end. She just wants it to keep going and going. Given the wealth of material and success, do you think we are looking at one of these shows that could be, you know, 9-10 seasons more? We could just keep going with it?
That's a really interesting question, because, you know, as I say, I love working with these phenomenal human beings, and I love creating this character. And of course, I will take it to a place where it hopefully will feel like it will end at its natural time. But, you know, on the other hand, I am an actress. I want to do other things. But at the moment, I'm very, very happy where I am now and the storylines and the storytelling that I'm doing.
Obviously, fans have their favourite lines, their favourite moments. When they meet you, are there any that they're particularly excited to share? Is there a lot of burning for you when they meet
you? You know, not yet, actually. Not yet. There's a lot of stuff on social media, you know, Flawless, My Dear, or, you know, all that kind of stuff, that my diamond, Diamond of the First Water, that kind of stuff is happening on social media. But I haven't had it actually personally said to me. I can't wait. It'd be great.
Thanks for a chat. Flawless, My Dear.